So we're here today with Joe LaRussa, who is running for re-election to the Farmington City Council. How are you today?
Very well. Thanks for having me.
Well, thank you for coming. Can you tell us why you decided to run for re-election?
So my first 2 years were all about demonstrating the commitment that I showed in the last election cycle to the things that I ran on then, which were a commitment to new technology and bringing those benefits to the city of Farmington, and also working on transformational redevelopment projects. And I think that the last 2 years I've been able to demonstrate how I've been able to execute on those things in terms of administratively making sure that we're executing on our plans. So within 75 days of getting elected, I was able to take a downtown master plan that was kind of languishing on the council and getting that across the finish line to approval and acceptance so that we could start executing on
it. Now, if you are reelected, what do you want to work on?
Well, like I said, my commitment to transformational redevelopment is still something I'm very passionate about. There are several projects in the city that encapsulate that, whether you're talking about the Maxville Training Center or the winery, but it goes beyond that because we've also recently released our master plan for the city, which also takes into account the outlying neighborhoods and critical projects that would create nodes or spaces for people to experience more of Farmington in terms of reaching out to the outlying neighborhoods. Like if you look down at the south side of Farmington, the gateway at 9 Mile and Farmington Road is one of the areas that's been identified as an opportunity area for us. And so I'm very excited that a lot of these projects now are going from more of a conceptualization phase to really planning something that can be actualized in our city.
Now, what is some of the professional experience that you bring to the table?
Yeah, so as a professional engineer, registered professional engineer in the state of Michigan, I bring a really good nuts and bolts understanding about the different things that the city has to do, whether it's road construction or water infrastructure, building buildings, things like that. So I bring a lot of technical expertise, but I also bring a lot of nonprofit and professional experience that I think matter in the city council. So the ability to collaborate well, how to find compromise. These are skills that I've honed in the workplace. I work in a very diverse automotive company where we have a lot of people with who are educated and opinionated, and so we have to find a way to get to a compromise. But also in the nonprofit sphere, again, everybody's in for the mission, but the way we accomplish the mission sometimes takes on different flavors, and we have to find a way to get to a compromise that where everybody wins something and we end up doing nothing, which is the ultimate loss in my
opinion. What are some of the ways that you've been involved in the Farmington community?
Yeah, so prior to getting on the city council, I did a bit of community organizing in my own neighborhood, but I also served on the design committee for the Downtown Development Authority, and I was also on the Downtown Master Plan Committee in 2016, where we worked on the master plan for the downtown area and brought that forward for actualization.
So in this race, there are a couple people running. Why should the voters pick you?
Great question. So the reason I think voters should pick me, number one, my creativity. I've been able to come up with ideas and things that we could do that are very different from maybe what I'll call the traditional or normal. Whether that's been pursuing funding that's outside of the tax base. So I have personally identified and pursued over $500,000 of grant funds for projects here in the city. I've also served for the last year on a municipal broadband task force with the city of Farmington Hills, where we're collaborating on talking about the next generation of infrastructure. Just like water, sewer, and roads were the 20th century infrastructure projects, I believe that municipal broadband is really that next level of infrastructure to bring more competition to our cities, to increase property values, and really provide an innovative benefit for residents and businesses to locate and reside
in Farmington.
So if
people want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
You can go to Facebook. You can find me at www.facebook.com/councilmanjoelarussa, all one word. You can also drop me an email, jlarussa@farmgov.com.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thank you.